So I can diagnose the problem a little more specifically in math. Here's a really cool problem. I like this. It's about defining steepness and slope using a ski lift. But what you have here is actually four separate layers. And I'm curious which of you can see the four separate layers, and particularly how when they're compressed together and presented to the student all at once, how that creates this impatient problem solving. I'll define them here. You have the visual, okay? You also have the mathematical structure, talking about grids, measurements, labels, points, axes, that sort of thing. You have sub-steps, which all lead to what we really want to talk about, which section is the steepest. So I hope you can see, I really hope you can see how what we're doing here is taking a compelling question, a compelling answer, but we're paving a smooth, straight path from one to the other and congratulating our students for how well they can step over the small cracks in the way. That's all we're doing here. So I want to put to you that if we can separate these in a different way and build them up with students, we can have everything we're looking for in terms of patient problem solving. So right here, I start with the visual, and I immediately ask the question, which section is the steepest? And this starts conversation, because the visual is created in such a way where you can defend two answers. So we get people arguing against each other, friend versus friend, in pairs, journaling, whatever. And then eventually, we realize it's getting annoying to talk about the skier in the lower left-hand side of the screen, or the skier just above the midline, and we realize how great would it be if we just had some A, B, C, and D labels to talk about them more easily. And then as we start to define, like, what does steepness mean, we realize it'd be nice to have some measurements to really narrow it down specifically what that means. And then, and only then, we throw down that mathematical structure. The math serves the conversation. The conversation doesn't serve the math. And at that point, I'll put it to you that 9 out of 10 classes are good to go on the whole slope steepness thing. But if you need to, your students can then develop those sub-steps together. Do you guys see how this right here compared to that, which one creates that patient problem solving, that math reasoning? It's been obvious in my practice to me. And I'll yield the floor here for a second to Einstein, who I believe has paid his dues. He talked about the formulation of a problem being so incredibly important. And yet, in my practice, in the US here, we just give problems to students. We don't involve them in the formulation of the problem.